Hello everyone, I'm Jesse Toombs with Toombs Art, and we just finished our painting today. I think it looks pretty good. I would like to go over some techniques I used and talk about the airbrush a little bit for you all that are a little unfamiliar with it. First you need a compressor. You can get that at the hobby shop, and then also you can get the airbrush gun at the hobby shop. I use an Iwata Eclipse, very nice gun. Also, this is a siphon feed. I have a gravity feed, but I like these, the siphon for stuff like this, just because I can get overall mood, lighting effects pretty easy with this. So one thing is you need to make sure that you get the right size, you know, the right bottles that fit into the bottom. And also, I like to pre-mix all my paints with the reducer. So all your paints, in order to flow through the gun, needs to be reduced. Sometimes you want a little thicker, sometimes a little thinner. Just depends on the project I'm working on. But so the thing I want to talk about is some of the techniques that I used. These are the triggers on these guns are. They're pretty sensitive, so I would suggest practicing on a separate piece of canvas or paper, whatever, just for practice. Get used to the feeling of this thing. So, one thing is I mainly used it for overall mood, which is a lot of the colorations to enhance the painting itself. So, yes, I did some of the sky. It helps blending versus a brush. You can see brush strokes. Well, with an airbrush gun, you can eliminate that and makes things go a little quicker. One thing is I want to show is when I do my lighting effects, especially the sun rays. The sun rays is done by when you're pulling the trigger, and then as you're moving up or away from the center of your circle, kind of pull away as you're moving. When I pull away as I'm moving, it allows the line to get larger. So that way it fades out, looks real nice. I also took, as you can see in the video, I took some colorations, other colors, and I sprayed to give some effects closer to the sun. And practice with it, get used to it. It's something that's that acquires a little bit of a feel for. So I hope that helps. I will be doing other videos showing more details on how to use the airbrush, how to maintain it, and all those things. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and have Have a good day.